Good afternoon to everyone gathered here. So today with us, we have Mr. Ram K. Krishnan, founder of Reach Skyline, a creative digital marketing startup company. Having started the company in 2016 at Madurai, he made possible the expansion of the company to Chennai also in 2018. It is our honor to welcome you and have you with us today, sir. As you know, we have gathered here for a small assignment. We would like to know a few information about your startup. So my friend Nandini would like to start ahead with the questions.
Thank you, Raksha. Hello, sir. Can you tell us Hi, sir. Can you tell about tell us something about your company and what motivates you to start this venture, sir?
So I'll start with what motivated me to start my venture. So basically, I was in college like you. I was doing my master's in business administration in Tyagaraja School of Management, another B school. Post my first year, I was doing my internship with Nestle. And then I found out that I'm not a person who is ready for any corporate jobs or any form of jobs. And so I wanted to do my own venture. And I was looking for options. What are all the kinds of business that are possible? And one day I found out, actually my business partner was two rooms away from my room in my hostel. He was selling t-shirts online. So it was very interesting for me. That was the first time I am seeing a person doing something like that. So I started talking with him, and within 4 to 5 days, I just did my own research on what it is, and we started the company. So the motivation was purely technology and the magic that the digital technology could actually do. So that was the motivation that led me to it. And one more thing was the entrepreneur spirit inside me, which said clearly, okay, you cannot work. You have to be an entrepreneur. So that was the motivation. And something about the company, I don't think that's... I do not know how to answer that question, something about my company.
So how did you procure the capital, initial capital for your company?
So that was a very hard, it was a very hard phase for me because I started this during my, post my first year. So I could not get money from my parents or anybody because they were very reluctant on me to continue my college. It was very hard. So we got around, I crowdfunded from my friends and my first family circle around 40 to 50,000 rupees, I think 5,000 to 6,000 rupees from all of them, something like that, to buy one computer. So that was my initial investment. And one good thing that happened to me post that was the college that I was studying in became my first client. So it was very helpful for me. So I got some money from that, which helped me in my initial investment.
Good morning, sir. What was the pricing strategy followed at the initial stage of the company? Is there any changes in strategy followed presently? If yes, could you tell the reason that led to change in pricing strategy of the business?
Okay, pricing, when I started, I had no idea of how to price the service that we were providing. It was purely a market research that I think for the first entire year, I tried different forms of pricing strategy. And one major reason why we moved to Chennai, I think we moved to Chennai within the first year of our operations in Madurai. We found out that the pricing that we fixed or the pricing that is viable to do this business, we were not able to get clients in a city, tier two city like Madurai. So that was one reason why we initially moved to Chennai. And so we had the pricing strategy. What we worked on was subscription model. So we call it the subscription model. The subscription model is the customer pays you in advance for the service for an entire year or for 6 months or for a quarter or something like that. And we provide them the service for them. So we basically act like their remote IT team or their remote digital marketing agency for our customers. So it is more of a subscription model per se, pricing strategy as it is a subscription model. And we have always been increasing, we tried Initially, the kind of services that we gave and the services that we are giving now has tremendously increased, kind of services, types of services. So the price also gradually increases. So the more value that we add, the more price that we are also able to provide to our customers.
Thank you for that input. Good morning. My question to you is, what strategy do you use to manage your market competition?
So I was looking into market competition as a fierce thing in the beginning. That is, okay, there are people competing. But the market that we are in, that is at per se per India, it is a very new market. So everybody in the market are literally, what you say, are exploring the market. So there is not much of competition. And even not just in our side, even at the end of our customers, a lot of our customers are just now getting into this. So it's not a big, highly competitive market, like you say, like an FMCG product, how the competition is going to be for the products. You know, you have to reduce your price, product placement. So there is not that much of competition right now in this market, but slowly it will come. So what we are trying to do, handled, we were sure that this issue would come for us in India in the near future, very sure. So we are trying to expand our markets. We are trying to get clients across the world now. Initially, when we started, we were very clear that we will only work with the regional clients. We will not work with international clients. But right now, we are looking for international customers also. We work with around 4 to 5 international businesses right now. And now we are trying to, okay, why not we go there and try to get business? So that is our next strategy when it comes to competition. So we want to expand our business more and more to other parts of the world also.
Okay, sir. A pandemic has hit hard business across sector. So in which way has it impacted the profit or revenue of your business?
The pandemic was very, very hard. It was a very hard hit on us. I think it was February, I think 2019. I think that was the time when we started an office in Hyderabad. We moved to Hyderabad. We planned to, okay, let us start doing business here. And then during March, I think March or May, I think 1 or 2 months later, we had the lockdown, everything across India. So a huge chunk of our profits, our investments got stuck there. And once the lockdown was there for the first 3 months, we had no business. But I had to keep my team alive. I had to keep my office alive. So it was a big hit. We had to spend a lot of money from our savings. We had to pay, even if we did not have business, we had to pay salary, keep our team alive. You know, you were given a commitment to them, so you had to do that. It was a good learning. I would not say a hit. Now we learned a lot, and we always think, okay, we have hit rock bottom, so nothing can now bring us down or stop us. So that's the confidence that the pandemic has given us. So it has kept us going, so we will go more.
Can you tell me something about how much time did your company take to attain profits? And were there any stage where you had no profit and no loss, a break-even point?
So I was very clear in that for maintaining break-even. Even until today, except for this pandemic period, we have never worked in a time when there is the company worked with no profit, no loss. When we started the company, we were 3 partners. So I was taking care of marketing and sales. The one of my other partner was into recruiting, and the other partner was into operations. So in each stage, as we are a service provider, our only cost would be more into human, like manpower is our biggest cost. So we always made sure only when we get business, we hire. So until now, we have never gone into a stage when it was a loss-making firm. We always maintain break-even. In situations like for the pandemic when it happened, the thing that we did is, as top management, we did not take salary. So that was one way how we avoided going into loss. So we always maintained, we even maintained break even during the first few months of the pandemic by us not taking salary from the company.
Tell us something about the cost and revenue of your business.
So as I said, the major cost for our business is the infrastructure. We have something called as an infrastructural cost. The infrastructural cost is basically the cost that we spend for our office, for our computers, and that's it. So that is a one-time cost. Our recurring cost is only human cost. That keeps on going, and I not want to reduce on my on cost of labor, because I believe creativity. And we work on creativity and development. It's expensive. It is expensive, basically. So we don't worry much. So what we try to do is we only try to get bigger customers and better clients who actually require, with our services, they also make money. And so that way, we do not have never worked on reducing costs. We only wanted to pay our people more. That's how we have been working. And the profits is by, the more service you give, the more money you can get from our customer, from any customer.
So my question to you is, what are the future plans for your company? Any plans for increasing the profits and the business?
So the first plan that I told you was, as I told, we are looking for overseas business. So we are planning to go to other countries and try to establish business there, and we look that as a very profitable source. We do not know the hardships of getting business, the sales hardship and the marketing hardship, but when we look at the returns per se, it is 5 to 10 times better than what we are getting from India. So that is one thing, and the other thing what we are doing is we have started a development company, that is a product development company. So we are into developing digital products, and right now we have recently developed a product called Edua. Edua is a school ERP system. We call it a SMS, school management system. And later we are also trying to make it into a CMS, a curricular management system. So eventually we are trying to get into the education market in India also, e-education market. So that is another way what we are looking at into development.
Thank you for that, sir.
Thank you so much for making time to speak with us, sir. We really enjoyed speaking with you, and we have a better understanding of how a startup functions, detail about pricing and competition strategy. Once again, thank you so much, sir.
Thank you so much for your time also. Have fun in college. Enjoy a lot. College time is something you don't get again and again.
Thank you. Bye. Thank you.